Hey everyone, Nick here again, and this is video number 4 in our series about how to analyze your zip codes. Now, in the last video, we used XLOOKUP formulas to get our city, county, and state pulled over from the full United States zip code database. I'm going to show you how to use VLOOKUP instead. So if you don't have XLOOKUP on your version of Excel, we're going to use VLOOKUP to do this. So the first thing I'm going to do is delete all the formulas that we have in our city, county, and state columns here. I'm going to just go ahead and drag all the way down. We only have 30 of them here. I'm going to right click and I'm going to click clear contents. When you clear contents, it clears everything, formulas and the text that you have in these cells. So now we're operating from a nice fresh spreadsheet. Okay, so just like the last video, anytime you insert a function or a formula in Excel, you have to start with an equal sign. So we're going to do that, and then I'm going to type in VLOOKUP instead of XLOOKUP. So we're going to type VLOOKUP, we're going to open the parentheses, and then it tells you what's the lookup value. I'm going to point to the zip code in that zip code column, and then it's going to ask me again for my table array. What table am I wanting to look up from? So now this is a little bit different than XLOOKUP, so I'm going to go back over to the zip code database, and I'm going to highlight all of the cells because it's asking me to highlight all of the columns in the table or the table array. So I have to highlight the entire thing. So we're going to go over here, A, and go all the way over to O, column O there, and then that's my table array. Now I'm going to put a comma in the formula, and now it's asking me what column is the index number. So I what I want them to do is what I want to do is count the number of columns over from the first column to the column that I want to pull from. So that's going to be the primary city. So that's in column D, so that's 1, 2, 3, 4. So I'm going to put 4 there. And then I'm going to, under range lookup, I'm going to say exact match because I don't want an approximate match. So I'm just going to say double click on that false, and then I'm going to close parentheses here. And if I push enter, it's going to take me back to my zip code list sheet, and the city is there. So let's do this again with county equals VLOOKUP, open parentheses, look up the value here, the zip code, comma, what's the table array? This is my entire table here. And now I want county, so what number column is county in this table? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So it's number 8. So I'm going to type that in there. The range lookup, I want an exact match, so I'm going to say false. Close parentheses and push enter. Perfect, there's Calhoun County. Let's do this one more time. VLOOKUP, open parentheses, look up this zip code here, comma, what's my table array? Highlight the entire table there. Let's put a comma here. What's the column for state? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we're gonna put 7 there and exact match. Now close parentheses and push enter. Perfect. Now I can double click, or I'm just gonna drag this all the way down. That's gonna be responsive. My formulas are going to be responsive and they're going to all populate here. And so there is another way, using VLOOKUP instead of XLOOKUP, to pull your city, county, and state information from the full database into your new zip code database based on your own list of zip codes. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and go ahead and hit the bell to subscribe to my channel for updates on DataViz, design, Excel, and PowerPoint tutorials. Remember, you don't have to be a professional to look like one using the software you already have access to and know how to use. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you next time.